Hello, welcome to the class PM. Now we are going to discuss about the new topic, percentages. Percentages, compared to the any topic in the arithmetic or reasoning, the percentages plays very important role, because percentages can place anywhere. Means in any questions we can include the percentages in time and work, work and wages, ratio and proportions, allegations and mixtures, profit and loss, simple interest, compound interest, or data interpretation. Every topic is interlinked with the percentages. So if you learn the percentage perfectly, you can solve the simple interest, compound interest question, profit and loss questions, some of the data interpretation questions very easily. So let's see the percentages topic. What do you mean by percentage? Everyone says percentage means it's 100%. Why it is 100%? Because the name itself defines percent. So we are calling century. Century means 100 years. Centimeters. Percent means per 100. We are comparing per 100. We are comparing everything with the 100 value. Okay. Though the first point in the percentage is, what is the percentage means? Percentage means comparison. It is nothing but the comparison. We are comparing with the value 100. So comparing with the value 100. The term percentage means for every 100. So we are comparing with the 100. Now here the basic concepts we have discussing is, first we have, you will know the ratio or fractions to percentage or percentage to fraction conversions. Let us see. Here some of the ratios to percentage and percentage to ratios conversions is there. So first try to remember this or try to get these values. So if there is any ratio or that's fraction, if you want to convert any fraction into percentage, we have to multiply that fraction with 100. Then if you want to convert the percentage into a fraction, then we have to divide that value with 100. That's it. Here is some examples. So here 1 by 1, it's a fraction. 1 by 1 is a fraction, is equal to 100%. 1 by 2 is a fraction, it is equal to 50%. So here I am multiplying with 100, 2 ones are 250s are. So we are converting fraction into percentage with multiplying with 100. So 50%. If you want to convert this into fractions, 50 by 100, when you place by 100, you have to remove this percentage symbol. Okay, then 5 ones are 5, 2 are 1 by 2, it is a basic operation. So 1 by 1 means 100%, 1 by 2 means 50%, like this. 1 by 3 means 33.33%, 1 by 4 means 25%, 1 by 5 means 20%, 1 by 6 means 16.67%, 1 by 7 means 14.2857, 1 by 8 means 12.5%, 1 by 9 means 11.11%, 1 by 12 means 8.33%, 1 by 13 means 7.69%. Like this, you have to remember up to 1 by 20. It's not mandatory, but if you know the values directly, then it is very easy to solve percentages, profit and loss, simple interest, compound interest, data interpretation, every problem. Believe, if you know this, if you understand this, if you remember this, it is very helpful to solve the remaining four topics, that are simple interest, compound interest, percentages, profit and loss, discounts, data interpretation. So everything is related with percentages. Let's discuss the short trick to remember these values. Okay, everyone should remember these values. Try to solve how 1 by 8 is 12.5. Multiply with 100. 8 ones are, or 2 fours are, 250s are, 2 twos are, 225s are. So what is the half of 25? 12.5. That is a 12.5%. We are converting fraction into percentage. It's clear? Now we are going to remember, what is the trick to remember these values? Here is the trick. We have to remember these values with a small story. So 3 belongs to is a fancy family. If you see, 1 by 3 is a 33.33%. 2 by 3 means 66.66%. These are the approximate value, not the perfect values. Okay, 66.66%. These values, observe these values. These are fancy numbers. You can find the celebrities' vehicle numbers. These are all 9s, all 6s, all 7s. These are the fancy numbers. Like that, here 1 by 3, 2 by 3. The value with the denominator 3, the fraction having denominator 3. Then if you convert that into a percentage, then it will have a fancy number. Okay? 1 by 3 is 33.33%. 2 by 3 means 66.66%. In this way, you can remember all the values which comes 3 in the denominator. Okay? Like this, next, sweet family. The 8 belongs to sweet family. Why? Because observe the values. 1 by 8 means 12.5%. 3 by 8 means 37.5%. 5 by 8 means 62.5%. 7 by 8 means 87.5%. These are the common values which are asking in the examinations. Any competitive examination, these are the values they are concentrating. Okay? Why it is called sweet family? Observe this. Every value ending with 2.5 or 7.5. 2.5 and 7.5. So the value which is repeating is 2.5 or 7.5. How to remember this value? Okay. 1 by 8 is 12.5%. 3 by 8. So I can write 3 by 8 in equal to 3 into 1 by 8. So what is the 1 by 8? 12.5. So 12 3 is 36 plus something, because 0.5 is there. So what is the possible conditions if you see one, you are converting 1 by 8 into percentage? Only there is two possibilities, 2.5 or 7.5. The value ending with 2.5 or 7.5. So consider the value 3 into 1 by 8 means 3 into 12.5. 12 3 is 36. So 36, you got 36. So possible values is 2.5, 7.5. Already this 36 value crossed the 2.5 and means 32.5 value. Okay, it's beyond this. The next possible condition is 7.5 only. So go to 37.5. It is the remember value. So consider 7 by 8. So I'm writing it 7 into 1 by 8. So 7 into 12.5. What is 12 7? 84. 84 is already crossed 2.5. The next possible value is 7.5 only. That's why 87.5. So 1 by 8, the value with the denominator 8 in the denominator, the fraction which has the value 8 in the denominator, when you are converting it into the percentage, the only possible condition is with ending with 2.5 or 7.5. Okay, this is called sweet family. Next, friends. 9 and 11 are both of friends. Okay, see, when 9 comes in the denominator, 11 table will comes here. Okay, in the fraction, 9 comes in the denominator, in the percentage, 11th table will come. Let us observe this. 1 by 9, the percentage is 11.11%. 2 by 9, 22.22%. 3 by 9, 1 by 3. So what is 1 by 3 value? 33.33%. So when 9 comes in the denominator, then 11th table comes in percentages. Okay, like this, when 11 comes under denominator, then 9th table will come in the percentages. 1 by 11 means 9.09. So to understand you, I place it 0 before the 9. So 09.9%. 2 by 11 means 18.18%. So observe this, when 9 comes under denominator, then 11th table comes in the percentages. When 11 comes in the denominator, 9th table will comes in the percentages. Like this, see the 7th and 14th. When 7 comes under denominator, 14th table comes in the percentages. When 14 comes in the denominator, 7 table will come in the percentages. 1 by 7 is 14.2857. 1 by 14 is 7.1428%. 2 by 7 means 28.5714. And 3 by 14 is 21.429. Like this, when 7 comes in the denominator, 14 table comes in the percentage. When 14 comes in the denominator, 7 table comes in the percentage. Like this, you have to remember the percentages values. What is that? Fancy value 3, sweet family 8, and friends 9 and 11, 7 and 14. The remaining values are you can remember easily. 1 by 4 as a 25%. 1 by 5, 20%. Okay. 1 by 2, 50%. Apart from these values, remaining values are these and they are easily rememberable. Okay. Let's go to the problems. What are the basic type of questions they will ask? Okay. The basic point is, A is what percentage of B? So, how you can write this equation? So, A is what percentage of B means, you are comparing A with B. Earlier we discussed what is percentage. Percentage means comparison. So, comparing, we are comparing A value with the B. So, what is the A value when comparing with the B means, I am comparing A with B in terms of percentage I want. That's it. So, the blind mark is the term which comes under of will comes in the denominator and the remaining part will comes in the numerator. So, see the next one. What percent of B is A? Now, how we can write this? B by A into 100. If you write like this, it is absolutely wrong. Because here, this and this is same. A is what percentage of B? You are comparing A with B. And I am asking this question in a different way. But the logic is same. What percentage of, I place this whole word or whole term in the first. What percentage of B is A? Means, here also we are comparing A with B into 100. Here, A is what percentage of B and what percent of B is A? Both are same. So, you are comparing A with B. Okay. Next one. A is what percentage more than or less than B? Okay. When comparing, because percentage means comparisons. A is what percentage more than B or less than B? Means, if I am discussing about the salaries or some sales of their company, well, comparing with the 2 years, okay? Talking of the more, so A is what percent more than B means, I am always comparing A with B in these three sentences. A is what percentage more means, the term B comes under denominator because we are comparing A with B. And more than, A is what percent more than B means, the difference between A and B by comparing the B into 100. If it is less, same difference between A and B, comparing with B, okay? When you solve the questions, you will understand easily, okay? Now, see the first question. 250 ml is what percentage of 5 liters, okay? 250 ml is what percentage in 5 liters? So, we are comparing 250 ml with 5 liters. Means, 250 ml with 5 liters. So, I am converting liters into milliliters because the another term is on the milliliters, so 5000 milliliters. But I want it in percentages, so I am multiplying this fraction into 100 to convert this fraction into percentages. 00, 25 ones are 25 20 is, okay? So 25 20s, so 1 by 20 into 100 means 5%. If you remember the fraction to percentage conversion, then no need to solve this. You can directly write, if you see 1 by 20, then you can remember, yes, 1 by 20 is 5%. Directly you can write. So, the basic question is, comparing one term with another term, we want the answer in terms of percentage. So, 250 ml is what percentage of 5 liters? So, we are comparing 250 ml with 5 liters. Let's go to the second question here. A person A's salary is 10,000 rupees, person B's salary is 15,000 rupees, okay? Their individual salaries. Now, I am comparing, so let us assume person A is me and person B is my wife, okay, my salary is 10,000 rupees and my wife's salary is 15,000 rupees. So I'm comparing both salaries. Who is having higher salary? Obviously, my wife having higher salary. So his salary is 10K. So my salary is 10,000 and my wife's salary is 15,000 or my friend's salary is 15,000 rupees. I'm comparing both the values. Okay. A is what percent less than B? Because A's salary is compared to B is less. So I'm comparing. So I'm comparing with whom? I'm comparing A's salary with B's salary. So denominator will come with 15K. Okay. So A is what percent less? Means what is the difference? How much A is less than B? 5,000 rupees. 5K. But I want in terms of percentage. 5 1 5 3 So 1 by 3 means 33.33%. So A is 33.33% less than B in terms of salary. Now second one, B is what percent more than A? So here I'm comparing B's salary with A's salary. So here I'm comparing B with A. The previous one I'm comparing A with B. Okay. Now here the reference is A. I'm comparing B's salary with A's salary. So the A salary will comes in the denominator, means 10K comes in the denominator. Next, what is the B salary? How much B is more than A in terms of salary? 5K into 100, then 1 by 2 means 50%. The question is different. The terms are same, but question is different. A is what percent less than B and B is what percent more than B. Okay, now first we done this, we are comparing A with B, so B as a reference. In second problem, we are comparing B with A. Now here the reference is A. In this way, we can solve the basic questions. Okay, comparison ones. So moving to the next one, it is very important topic for all the competitive examinations, and anytime it is a basic one to solve the maximum number of questions from compound interest, simple interest, discounts, profit and loss, successive percentages. Okay, the topic name is successive percentages. It can applicable for discount problems, compound interest, simple interest. Okay, now see the concept. A salary is increased by X percentage. Okay, 1%. If my salary is increased by 10% because my work is good, if my owner feels is working good, then he increases my salary 10%. After some days, I done a mistake. Then my salary decreases by 10%. Now, what is the overall change in my salary? Okay. Now, initially, consider initially my salary is 1,000 rupees. Okay. Due to the goodwill, 10% increases. Means, what is my next salary? So, what is the 10% of 1,000? 100 rupees. Now, my salary is 1,100 rupees. After increment. Now I done a mistake, then my salary is decreased by 10%. Then everyone think 10% increased and 10% decreased, so there is no change in the salary. Everyone will think like this, but it's wrong, because when 10% is increased, my reference value is 1,000. When 10% is decreased, my reference value changed. Okay, now my reference value is 1,100 rupees. Now, what is the 10% of 1100 rupees? It's 110 rupees. So, 110 rupees are deducted from my salary. Then what is it? It's 1090 rupees or 990 rupees. It's 990 rupees. Okay? It's my salary. Now, compared to the initial value, what is the deduction in my salary? What is the overall change in my salary? 1% decrease. That's it. 1%. Yes, 1% decrease. Overall, I got a deduction of 1%. In this type of questions, we are using successive percentages. So, let us see the questions. How we can solve this type of questions? Using, there is a formula. It's a very easy formula. Plus or minus x, plus or minus y, plus or minus xy by 100. Means, when there is an increase, successive increase, A salary is increased x percentage. So, I am considering plus x. And next, decreased by y percentage. Now here the next one is successive, next one is decreased. So I am considering the negative value. If for example A salary increased by X percentage and next increased by, here increased by Y percent, then I will take plus X plus Y plus XY, because X is positive, Y is positive, their product will be positive 100. If my salary is increased X percentage initially, then decreased by Y, then plus X minus Y, plus X into minus Y, minus XY by 100. In this way, this formula we are useful. Okay, let's go to the problems. Length of a rectangle is increased by 20%, breadth increased by 30%. Okay, there is a rectangle. Okay, it is a rectangle. Yes, so I am increasing the length 20%. I am increasing the breadth also 30%. Then my length increases, my breadth increases. There is a change in the area. So what percentage of area is changed? What is the overall change in the rectangle area? See, so here increasing in the length. So initially 20% increases. So plus 20. Second, breadth also increases, means plus 30. Overall 20, 30, 600. Plus into plus, because both are increased, plus 100. So 20 plus 30, 50, 50 plus 6, 56. So overall change is 56%. What is this? Overall change in the area is 56%. Okay? In the other way, everyone thinks, first consider 100 is the length, 20% increases. So new length is 120 centimeters. Okay? The breadth is also 100 or something 50. Then the new breadth after 30% increase means it is 65. Then overall what is the change in? So they use L into B formula. Okay, L into B formula. Then they try to find out previous area and after increment area and compare with this and compare with the previous value. It is a very lengthy and time taking method. So don't use this equation forming or try to creating a new equations. Okay, avoid this way. Please use this successive percentage. Okay, how this successive percentage helpful in the other problems? Let us see. Price of an article is increased by 25%. So I have this sketch pen. So first I am increasing this value 25%. Then I am decreasing. If a person came to my shop and is a known person, very close friend of me, then I decrease it 30%. Then what is the overall change in the price of the article? So everyone, major number of students will consider, they will consider example, let us assume the value of the article is 100 rupees. Then they will increase that value with 25 rupees, then decrease 30%. So it's a very time taking process. Don't use that one, successive percentage. When you use successive percentage, so first there is increase in the price 25 plus, then there is a decrease, so minus 30. So 25 into 30, it's a 1500 or 750. So plus into minus, minus by 100, X, Y, X, Y. So cancel this, 25 minus 30, minus 5. 515 is a 52 is a minus 7.5, 15 by 2, so minus 12.5. So it is a percentage. So overall 12.5% change in the price of the article. So it is a total. Minus means it is a decrease, it will represent a decrease. Okay, plus means it represents an increase. So there is a total. Overall percentage change in the price of the article is 12.5%. Okay, in this way we can solve the basic questions which are related with successive percentages. In the upcoming videos of simple interest, compound interest, profit and loss, discounts, we will discuss and we will use this successive percentage very efficiently. Okay, remember this, if the increment then you use plus, if there is a decrement use minus. Okay. Now the next concept, it is very important. A into B equal to K. K is a constant. What is A, what is B and what is K? Okay. Which way? Some of the concepts will follow this rule. okay? A into B, what are the applicable times? Okay, let us assume here concept. First see the concept. 3 into 5 is equal to 15. 5 into 3 equal to 15. Here 15 is a constant. My result is constant, but to make this result constant, so there is a changes in the terms. Here that is a A, that is a B, this is K. Okay, 3 into 5 equal to 15. So I am increasing this first term A into 2 parts extra, then 5. To maintain the result 15 const as a constant, I have to decrease the another unit by 2 units. Okay, everyone understood? So here my first term, I am increasing 2 points. So it becomes 5. But I want my result, answer is constant. To make it constant, I am decreasing the another term with 2 points. Then the result is constant. Okay, in this way, there is some concept follow this rule. Speed into time equal to distance. Okay, if I am increasing the speed, okay, from my office to home, I have the common distance. The distance will not change. Okay, if I am increased regularly, I am going with 60 kilometers per hour speed, then it will take 30 minutes to reach my home. Okay, if I am increasing my speed to 80 kilometers per hour, then the time taken to reach my office is less, because when speed increases, time decreases, because the distance is constant here. Next one, men and days equal to work. So as we discussed in the time and work problems, when number of men are increased, complete the work is decreased, because work is constant. Constructing a work, using 2 workers, it takes 5 days. Then if I use 10 workers, then it is completed within 1 day. So when men increased, number of days will decrease. Okay, when length increased, to maintain the area constant, okay, to maintain the area of a rectangle or a square or anything, to maintain the area constant, if I am increasing the length, automatically you should decrease the breadth, because to maintain the area constant. Vice versa, if you are increasing the breadth and to maintain area constant, I have to decrease the length. In this way, the price, quantity, expenditure, it is a very, very important, and every time in SI and any groups, this is a question, every time they are asking. Price into quantity equal to expenditure. Example, I have 100 rupees. I went to a market. I want to purchase 10 apples. Okay, within 100 rupees, my budget. So every month I used to maintain my budget as same. So I am allocating 100 rupees for my fruits. Okay, so 100 rupees is my expenditure for the fruits. I got 10 apples. So my price is 100 rupees. Okay, price is 10 rupees for each apple. Quantity 10 apples. My expenditure is 100 rupees. Okay, if the price of the apple is increased, it becomes 15 rupees. Then I don't want to invest more on my fruits. Okay, I don't want to change my budget. So, but then I will get less number of apples. The quantity will decrease, because I am not changing my expenditure. So the price is also increased. Then I will get less number of apples. In this way, when price increases without changing the expenditure, we have to change the quantity or consumption. Okay, this type of questions will follow this A into B equal to K rule. Okay, how this problems will solve? Okay, let's see the formulas here. I think it's not a formula, it's a basic concept. If one term is increased, like it's a percentage or fraction, so the major trick here is, they will ask in the question, they will give the data in terms of percentage. Then we have to convert the percentage into fraction. Then it is very useful. So if A is increased something 20%, then I am writing this 20% in terms of 1 by 5. So if A is increased or length is increased 20%, then to keep the area constant, how much percentage of breadth I have to decrease? This is a question. Then you have to decrease numerator by denominator plus numerator. Okay, why we have to add numerator and denominator in the denominator portion? Because if a fraction is there, 1 by 2, what is the value? 50 or 0.5 in terms of value. decimals. Okay, if I am increasing the denominator value 1 by 3, then its value is 0.33, 1 by 4, 0.25. If I am increasing the denominator, the overall value is decreasing. So here also I have to decrease because one term is increasing. So alternately I have only one chance to decrease the another term. So to decrease the term, I have to increase the denominator value. One denominator plus numerator. In the same way, if the one article is, or one quantity is decreasing, I have to increase the another quantity to maintain the constant, or resultant is to maintain the result as a constant. Okay. So here, how the another value is increased? Then here the negative value. If 1 by 3 is 0.33, I am decreasing the denominator 0.5, 1 by 1, 1. Okay. When I am decreasing the denominator value, the overall value increasing. So the condition is one part is decreasing. Obviously, we have to increase the another term or item to maintain the resultant is constant. Then how much I have to increase? Numerator by numerator minus denominator. If you decrease the denominator, the value will increase. If you increase the denominator, the value will decrease. In this way, we are going to solve the problems. Okay. Which type of problems will follow this increasing, decreasing? Let us see. With the previous problems and previous some of the problems relate which are same as with the some changes in the data in the previous essay problems. If the price of rice is raised by 25%, please observe. In all the examination, they will ask about rice and sugar or apple. These are the three quantities always they will ask. Okay. If the price of rice is raised by 25%, the price of the rice is increased 25%. Find how much percentage must a householder reduce his consumption so as to maintain the expenditure constant. So there is 1%. Here is the 1%. So he is allocating his monthly budget. He is allocating 1,000 rupees for the rice. Okay, for 1,000 rupees he is getting 20 kgs of rice bag. Okay, but in the next month the price of the rice is increased by 25%, but his salary is not increased to change his budget, but he wants to maintain the budget as it is. He don't want to spend another extra amount on the rice. His budget is 1,000 rupees only. Now the price is increased. Now in this condition, he will get 20 kgs or not? No, he will never get 20 kgs because the price increased, but the expenditure will not, we are not changing. So the quantity will decrease. So price into quantity equal to expenditure. So price is increased by 25%. Automatically, I have to maintain this expenditure as a constant. I have to decrease this quantity. Automatically, I have to decrease the quantity. If I want, if my rice 25% means 250 rupees increase. Okay. Now here for 1250 rupees, I will get 25 kgs of rice. Okay. If I want 20 kgs of rice, then I have to spend 250 rupees extra. But I don't want to spend extra money. Then I will get less kgs of rice here. The price of the rice increased by 25%. Then, to maintain the expenditure constant, I have to reduce my consumption. How much I have to reduce? Once go through that formula, as a term increased by numerator by denominator, the next term has to decrease by numerator plus denominator. Now, I am writing this 25% as 1 by 4. I am converting the percentage into fraction. Now here 1 is the numerator, 4 is the denominator. This term is increased. So I have to reduce the another term. How much I have to reduce? Numerator by 1 by numerator plus denominator means 4 plus 1, 5. I have to reduce 1 by 5. So I am converting this 1 by 5 into percentage, 20%. So if the price of the rice is increased by 25%, so to maintain the expenditure constant, I have to reduce my consumption 20%. Simple, three steps or two steps we can solve this question. Let's move to the next question. One side of a square is increased by 20%. Okay, the side of a square, So let us consider a square, all sides are equal. So I am increasing this one side with 20%. So if I am increase this 20%, it's not a square. If all sides are equal, then only it is a square. If I am increasing one side, then it is changing. But I have to maintain the area same. Area is same. I have to maintain this area same. Even though I increased the side or length, what should I have to do? To maintain the area same, I have to decrease the another side. Okay, then same length into breadth equal to area. I want to maintain area as constant. So I already am increasing the length. I have to decrease the breadth. Is the only one chance. So how much length increased? 20% means I'm converting it into fractions. What is 20% in terms of fraction? 1/5. So it is the increased value. So I have to decrease the next term. How much I have to decrease? Numerator by 1 by numerator plus denominator. 5/5 + 1, 6. So I have to decrease 1/6 means 16.67% breadth I have to decrease to maintain area constant. Within 2 steps we can solve this type of questions. But practice this concept, practice this type of solving, then it is very helpful in your examination. Let's move to the next question. Mohan increased his speed while traveling, then what is the decrease in the time when distance is constant? Okay, let us consider Mohan is traveling from office to home. Okay, office to home. Okay, regularly. So Mohan increased his speed while traveling, then what is the decrease in the time when distance is constant? Okay, how much increase? We don't know because the data is not given. Okay, in this type of question, don't try to solve the questions. Directly go to the data insufficient option. Okay, here I have not mentioned any value. Mohan increased his speed. How much? While traveling to office to home. Then what is the percentage decrease in the time? Okay, let us assume Mohan increased his speed while traveling from office to home. 30% increase. So I am increasing my speed 30%. Distance is constant. So speed into time equal to distance. It is constant and speed is increased. So the only one chance I have to maintain the distance constant, I have to decrease the time. Obviously, if you increase the speed, time automatically time will decrease. The time taken to reach the destination will decrease. So how much speed I am increasing? 30%. So 30% means I am converting it into fraction, 3/10. Is it right? Yes. 1/10 means 10%. So 3/10 means 30%. So 3/10 increased. Okay, 3/10 increased. So I have to decrease the time. How much I am decreasing? Numerator by 3 by denominator. 10 + 3, 13. I have to decrease the decrease in the time. Okay, here when you increase the speed, automatically time is decreased. So how much percentage of time decreased means 3 by numerator plus denominator, 3/13. So 3/13 means 1/13 means 7.69. So 3 × 7.69, approximately it is equal to 23% decrease in the time. In this way, we are using this increment decrement concept in the percentages. Okay, remember the value, remember the concept, and please try to practice with the practice questions. In this type of model, I'm giving more number of problems for the practice session. So please try to use this method. If you are thorough with this method, you can solve any question within 10 seconds. Okay, then move to the next concept, type 4.